Hey everyone, today we'll be reviewing text analytics within Azure's AI Cognitive Services. This is an amazing tool to plug into a bot or any other smart application. This tool is great for determining the speaker's content, sentiment, language, as well as what they're trying to talk about. As a quick example, if McDonald's is mentioned in conversation, the bot knows this is a popular fast food chain, just like you or I would know. So, how does a bot decipher all this, and how can we build a bot that reacts to a person naturally as they speak? Let's take a look at a bot that I've built in the past that does just this. Now, first things first, head over to portal.azure.com. And we're going to start by creating a text analytics API. To do this, head over to Azure and click on Create a Resource. Type in text analytics. And select the first option that shows up. Now, click on Create, follow the prompts, and you should end up with an API key that you can use in your bot. Copy and paste that API key into a safe location so you can use it easily later on. Now, head over to Visual Studio. I already have a bot open over here that we're going to use. You want to be sure to paste in your API key somewhere in your bot code and use it later on when you're making the API call. Now within your bot, you're going to want to intercept the user query and send that as a text string to the service. What's going to happen is it's going to return a JSON response, and users can then parse that to get details using standard .NET or C# methods. Now to start our bot, go ahead and click IIS Express. This might take a few seconds, but it should open up a web page that tells you that the bot is ready for testing. Go ahead and minimize this for now and open up your bot emulator. Hit Restart Conversation. So our bot today is a personal assistant that helps with restaurant reviews, restaurant reservations, hotels, flights, what have you. So let's talk to our bot about our last reservation that we made through the bot. For the first example, we're going to want to give the bot a positive reaction or a positive statement describing something we've experienced in the past. So let's go ahead and type in the following statement. Perfect. So we see how our bot has assessed this communication. Now, first, we can see that it's detected that our language is English, which is perfect. So we can see that our sentiment score over here, which provides an insight on whether the user reacted positively, negatively, neutrally, or what have you. And we can see in this case that the bot identified this statement as positive, which makes perfect sense. The sentiment score is 100%, which makes sense given the phrasing that we used within our statement. Now, the bot also parsed the sentence to determine words it finds useful or not. So in this case, right below our sentiment score, we can see our list of key phrases within this statement, which are Nobu restaurant, weekend, and sushi. Now, we can combine these three phrases with the sentiment score to get a good indication of what the user is trying to communicate. It also helps eliminate filler words like to, the, and, it, and so on. Now, additionally, we can see that it found named entities within our query, and it labeled Nobu restaurant as a location. It also labeled the word restaurant by itself as a location, and it labeled the weekend as a date time entity. Now, why are entities useful and why are they important? We can program our bot to recognize entities like dates and times, locations, such that we can extract this information and use it to book, for example, restaurant reservations or flights, hotels, vacations. This is especially useful because it extracts information like date-time fields so the developer doesn't have to. Now, lastly, we can see that the bot even found Wikipedia articles for both restaurant as well as Nobu. We can embed these links and articles in a bot response to provide the user with even more information. And that's the great thing about using a bot, is we're able to give the user just as much information as they require, and we can dig into further detail if the user asks for it. Now, if we turn the statement around and type in something negative, for example, let's see how the bot reacts to that. Now we can see in this case, the sentiment has changed to 77% negative. So this is a really good example to show that we can use these sentiment scores to gauge a user's mood and tailor our services accordingly. Apart from sentiment, we can see that the language was determined to be English again, and it extracted pretty much the same key phrases and entities as our last statement. Another excellent feature of this API is being able to detect and translate between languages. So in this case, let's give the bot a query, but in French. Perfect. So you can see that the bot detected a neutral sentiment in this case, which makes sense, given that we asked the bot a question. And the language in this case is French. Now, assuming that we're working in English over here, we can use language services to translate user queries to English, process the query, and then return an answer back to the user in French, or whichever language they started with. We'll take a look at this further when we look at the translator text service. Now, all this is great, but in many cases, we'd like to collect and analyze this data over time, get metrics, and see how our bot is doing and responding to various users. Now, if you'd like to collect and analyze bot data over time, you can always store all this information in an Azure database and connect it to Power BI and create an analytics dashboard. I'll show you a quick example of that over here. So this gives you a visual summary of all bot activity and even the average sentiment expressed by the user. If we look at the top left diagram, we can see most queries are positive, and we have a handful of neutral as well as negative queries. So we can see that just this service alone provides a ton of data in terms of analyzing user queries and sentiments. We can strengthen this further by making use of language understanding services. Now, this service is slightly more advanced and requires a bit more development experience. And what that does is it lets you build and train artificial intelligence models to categorize user queries even further and extract even more data. Stay tuned for that video to learn more. So if you like this video, please like and subscribe to our channel, as we'll be posting a lot more videos to help you build your Azure bot.